Dave, most people who've been in the spotlight as much as you have would rather just fade away, but you're not doing that.
No, Steve, I'm not. And the media has a big impact on the voters. They control a lot of the politics with issues. And really in the past, I can care less what the media thinks. I'm a person about what does my constituents want? What does the people in my district want? And I've always been the type of person who's just, they come to me and ask me a question. I give an honest answer whether I think they're gonna like it or not. And it's working with the people of the district. And I've run three very successful campaigns and won by a large amount of votes. And it's working with the people of your community, the people who have trust in you and the people that like you. And I have a lot of people out there in the district that have come to me and asked me, hey, Dave, we don't want you to fade away from politics because you've done such a great job. You took an office of constable that was a nothing job, and you've worked in the community. You told us you were going to go out and write parking tickets. You told us you were going to go out and police the community, and that's what you've done, regardless of all the scrutiny you got from Metro Council before and different politicians that you were out there, and that's what we want. We want somebody that's going to be honest with us, and that's what I do. I'm honest with my voters.
Metro Council did try to limit your duties and your authority as a constable. Is this kind of a way to get back at them?
No, naturally not. I don't hold grudges against people. It, like I said, the past it is what it is. And of course, they feel like they're doing what they feel they're doing that's the right thing. And that's in politics. Sometimes we make decisions based off of, you know, sudden decisions that happen in the community, and we're always fast to react. But we need to sit back and look at that and say, okay, is this a good thing for the future for us, or is it a bad thing for the future? And I think a lot of times we react out of spite sometimes just because of we have no control over our constables. So let's see what we can do to limit their authority and power. So it gives them a little bit of an issue to address, and at the time that's what they felt was right, and that's what they did.
Well, now this isn't the first time you thought about running for Metro Council, because you attempted about a decade ago, and you said then that you'd be back.
I'm back, that's correct. I ran against the 12th district. That's when I lived in the 12th district, which was against councilmen. That's when the first merger of government was, and that's when everybody was putting their name out there in politics, and they were trying to get fresh in. And Rick Blackwell was a very strong, very, very strong candidate, had a lot of community ties, and he got the position, and he does a fine job at it.
Mm-hmm. You know, one of those races you won was for county commissioner, which had no duties, and I don't think any pay at the time. Why did you decide to run for county commissioner?
It's a stepping stone for politics. It was a write-in position. There was three or four people that were on the ballot for write-in. I had over 65,000 write-in votes. 65,000 people went to the poll and physically wrote my name in on the ballot. It was 68,000, I think, total votes that were cast. 65,000 of them were for me, and that goes to show you right there, people in the community, you know, I put a good platform up and you know, and told the people of the community, you know, what I was going to do and help out, and that's what I did. And then we did do a lot of stuff as county commissioner, mm-hmm. Though there was no pay and duties. We helped get out with Operation Brightside, picked up trash and leaves, and tried to help keep the community clean, and people saw that. So they knew that I told them what I was going to do, and I continued to, with my promise to them. I didn't lie to them. And the people just want to be told the truth. They just don't want to be lied to.
What needs to be done in your mind to the council district that you want to represent?
There's a lot of big issues. Councilwoman Warwich has done a great job with the office she's in. She's just gotten a little stale. She's lost touch with the people and the community. It's like with any job. You get in there. She's been a councilwoman for almost a little over a decade, and she's just, you know, people with their jobs, they get laid back, they get in their positions, and they lose touch. And a lot of constituent districts have come to me and said, Dave, Mary Woolridge, when she first got elected, did an outstanding job in the community. We feel like we're out of touch with her. We feel like that the ideals that she has is just not working. And the issues in the district that I want to improve is, I want to create job programs in the community, after school programs for our children to come to after school, help with their homework, help their test scores out in schools. That's a big issue with our school system now, is that the kids are struggling at home. They're struggling. Parents work now, and both parents work, and the kids aren't getting the education they need at home. And to have after school programs at our community centers, especially with the budget crunch, and with all around the U.S. with education, we need to work with these children on a one-on-one basis. Another issue is creating more police presence on the street to help this more community-oriented policing, getting the people and the citizens of those communities out onto the street to work with people hand-in-hand where these teenagers and these adults can feel like they can go to the police and tell them about the issues and problems and feel trusted with them. Another issue is we have a lot of vacant homes, people foreclosed on homes that are falling apart that's in the communities. Get those turned over for gardens and get the communities turned over to where we can get Habitat for Humanity to keep the people in the community in low-income housing that they can afford to be first-time homeowners and live in the same community in which they grew up in. Another issue is there's a lot of overgrowth. The alleys are dirty, the streets are dirty. Myself and my office staff and volunteers in the community get out and roll our sleeves up and help these people clean up their communities with rakes and trash bags and walk around and have quarterly community conversation meetings as the former mayor Jerry Abramson had in the community. Each quarter have people come out and let us know what problems are in the district, stuff that I may not be able to see, and get these residents' ideals on what's going on. And as a matter of fact, the voters are your boss. I mean, they can keep you or they can get rid of you, and you need to work with everybody in the community, whether they're a voter or they're even not a voter, and just keep things going.
Aren't you concerned just a little bit that all your history is going to be resurrected by you running for Metro Council?
I'm sure it will. You got some different types of voters. You got voters who sit at home, watch the TV, and don't do nothing. It's like something as you and I are going to the barber shop. You got the person sitting in the barber chair and belly aches and gripes all day that about the issues in the neighborhood, but they don't go to the polls and they don't vote to make a change. And then you got the people like me who sit there and they listen to those people and they're like, maybe I do need to change something, or maybe I could look into changing something. But all your voters are actually going to have different things. There's a lot of people out there who, unfortunately, they think I'm a hero because of what I did, because they can't afford prices when they go to the grocery store. And you got people out there that think I was a cowboy. But the people who truly know me in the community, the people who vote for me over and over and over again, I'm doing something right because I keep getting reelected, that know me personally, know that I'm a nice guy, I give you the shirt off my back anytime you'd want it. I'm a person in the community that cares. I have a big heart. And those are the people, that's who they want in office. And the people who don't know me, who are just looking at the news blogs or the negative media attention on there, they're the ones who make the decision. But a lot of those people don't even go to the polling vote. They're the ones who sit at home. And the people who know me know what type of person I really am. And those are the people I think that will carry me through this election.
I mean, is there something just deep down that makes you want to serve the public?
It's a passion. I've always had a love to help people and to fix problems. I hate turmoil. I hate people that are unhappy. I'm always the cheerful person in the group that wants to make the other person happy. And it bothers me that why do we have problems in today's America? Why can't we all just get along? Why can't we all just love one another? And I was brought up in a church family that, you know, turmoil wasn't a big thing for us. We don't live for drama. And we just want to work in the community with our people, and I've always had a passion to serve the community and fix something in some way.
But you have to know going into this that you're going to have a lot of detractors and a lot of people sitting back going, why?
That's their decision. Do we live in America where people can run for what they want to run for, they can do what they want to do, and we all have a right to our opinions? And that's their opinion. I hope I can change their opinion, but if I don't, I don't. And the people will show on the May primary, May 20th, they'll show whether they want me in office or not, and we'll go from there.
So is Metro Council a stepping stone to something else?
Possibility, yes.
Okay.